We nearly begin all of our processing in the wet processing area of the Food Innovation Lab. Fresh produce comes in, we sort it, blanch it, peel it, utilizing the equipment in this part of the facility. So we have a blanching tank here. Blanching is a process used to inactivate enzymes which cause deterioration of the fruits and vegetables rapidly. We also then would go from there to peel it. Peeling, we can utilize an ice water bath, or we can use a lye bath, or we have a mechanical peeler for things like carrots and potatoes that are a little bit tougher to get the skin to break. From there, the processing can move to a number of different directions. We can purify our products, or puree our products, in this liquefier. It does quite a nice job of making 50 pounds of soup in a blink. But we also can take it here and make hummus, or we can make mayonnaise or salad dressings in a high shear emulsion pump. From there, other things that we can do are press out juices. A number of fruits and vegetables are being used today for juice beverages. So we have to have a number of different configurations to extract juice. So we have bladder presses, we have an extractor finisher, we have a traditional juicing machine. We also can make chopped vegetables using the Urschel Sprint 2 machine. This machine will slice, dice, crinkle cut, and a number of other different configurations. Now, some people want to retort their product, put it in cans, and have it sterilized so it can be shelf stable for a number of months or years. The first step after we fill a can is to put it in this machine and seal the tin can or the aluminum can that we're working with. From there, we go to the All-PAX 2402 retort. This particular retort is equipped, again, with computerization so we can determine our thermal death time curves and process the product to make it as sterile as possible. We're in the thermalization and packaging area. And this area is the last step most foods see before they're ready to be eaten by our consumers. First piece of equipment I want to talk about is our swept surface heat exchanger. This piece of equipment is used to sterilize things like nut butters, hummus, anything thicker in nature. When the products come out of here, they are literally ready to eat. Some of the other equipment we have in the facility, this is a piece of equipment made by Sinovatec out of Raleigh, North Carolina. Sinovatec makes a continuous microwave processor, so it uses microwave energy to sterilize the food. We can actually do soups in this particular piece of equipment with particulates up to 3/4 of an inch. One of the other things we like to do with this particular piece of equipment is do subcritical hot water extraction to extract natural colors, flavors, and bioactives. The fruit juice industry over the past few years has had to look for different ways to pasteurize and sterilize their products, yet retain that beautiful color and flavor that we're all used to. One of the methods they're utilizing is ultraviolet light pasteurization. This particular cabinet can do that piece of a process. When we're ready to fill our products into packaging, one of the things we have is a bottle filler. This particular piece of equipment allows us to fill 1 ounce to 2 gallon plastic bottles or aluminum bottles. One of the process steps for beverages is done in a microthermic indirect steam processor. This particular piece of equipment is utilized by the beverage industry every day to pasteurize and sterilize the beverages we consume. If we have high fat products that we want to also pass through here, we have an homogenizer that allows us to reduce the particle size of a fat globule. Another piece of equipment we have in our facility is a 50 gallon vacuum pan processor, which allows us to do things like jams and jellies, condensed soups. It's a great way to remove water under vacuum. Now, all products have to be packaged. We have a number of different packaging configurations in our facility. We have a bag and box filler that allows us to do 1/2 gallon to 3 gallon packages. We have a piston pump filler for more viscous things like nut butters, frostings, icings. We have a small powder machine that allows us to do small packets anywhere from 1 gram to 50 grams. And we also have an auger filler, which is just a typical filler that can fill a number of different bag configurations. Many powdered products need to be blended together after different powders have been manufactured. Here we have a paddle blender. We chose a paddle blender over a ribbon mixer simply because it's a gentler method of blending powders together without shattering the particle size. Now, a number of our customers are also interested in having a very particular particle size. In order to get to those particular particle sizes, we may need to mill the powders we remove from our freeze dryer or our spray dryer. Here we have a hammer mill attached to a fruit milling piece of equipment. This enables us to go from 10 millimeters size particle all the way down to 50 microns. After we've milled the powder, we may need to sift it, and we have the capability to sift and get various particle sizes through the action of sifting. We're entering the extraction room, the Food Innovation Lab. Equipped in this facility, we have the Armfield FT29 solvent extraction unit, which is capable of using solvents like ethanol, methanol, chloroform, hexane, to extract natural colors, natural flavors, and bioactives. Also in this room, we have a cross-flow membrane filtration unit that's capable of doing ultrafiltration, diafiltration, microfiltration, and reverse osmosis in a number of different configurations. This also allows us to isolate individual proteins, as well as bioactive components. We're in the drying room of the Food Innovation Lab, and in this room, we have several different configurations of drying equipment usually utilized to manufacture food ingredients. The first superstar in this lab is the GEA spray dryer that we have that's capable of drying just about any type of powder and removes about 4 to 8 kilograms of water per hour. This one is very configured so we can do just a large number of different products. We also have a freeze dryer in this facility, and the freeze dryer and the spray dryer both are well equipped with computerized methods that allow us to take the scale from this small scale to a full scale production with easy translation for our customers. Freeze drying is typically used today for products that are much more sensitive to heat, so we use freeze drying in that instance. Our product development lab was designed with two things in mind. One was actual new product development in plant-based foods, but the other one was at some point you have to cook these products. And so we didn't build a residential kitchen, we built a commercial kitchen.
We set this lab up as a part of it's a test kitchen, which is more like a restaurant environment with, you know, nice range and griddle, just like you would see in a restaurant. And then the other half is the product development lab. And we set it up in stages. It's gonna really depend on what our customer needs are. But we have a confection station, a meat analog or meat substitute station. We will also do entrees there, plant-based entrees. We have a bakery section and we have a beverage section. We have a QA/QC quality control, quality assurance. We would do product testing in there, such as water activity, moisture analysis, color analysis, just a number of different things as far as testing of the product.
We have in our facility a rational combi oven. Combi ovens today are being utilized by more restaurants and hotels because they're a rapid method of cooking. They cook utilizing humidity and heat and can hold temperature for an extended period of time. This particular oven also can give us some very unique roasted colors, roasted flavors that aren't possible utilizing a normal oven. A few of the construction features of our facility include the walls being covered by Credite. Credite is a polymer approved by the United States Food and Drug Administration for use in food plants. It's very easy to clean, it's very durable, and it's non-penetrable. The floors have been covered with an epoxy concrete, 9 layers thick. It rises from our drains that have baskets in them up to the walls 3.5 inches. So that as water gets on the floor, it drains through to the drains quite easily. Ceilings are all washed down, so we can wash down the ceilings. And we have security cameras throughout the facility. We've put equipment on wheels so we can move things out of the way when we don't need them on a given day. But we've also put things on wheels so we can get them out of the way and bring new things in. The electrical drops are plugged into a fuse bar above our head. We can plug new fuses in and drop new voltage lines if we need to. We have water lines above our head so we can tap into them and bring new water lines down to our equipment also.